structure, there's a trees hierarchy for tasks and goals. There could be a trees hierarchy for roles, could be one for objects, and could be one for object or data. But that could also be data flow, or workflow, or object flow. So be aware that, that there are more different types of structures. So this is a tree structure, and I on purpose take one from another approach. This is Fabio Patello's Conquer Task Tree, and this is his hierarchical structure of tasks. Have you seen Fabio Patello's work?
No.
No? Well, it's in a way the same story, but written in a different way, and he makes a difference between activities or tasks of a person, activities that are related to communication. And so you can see this is a communication task, and this is an individual person task, reading a draft, I don't have to communicate, is the idea. So there are many different ways to do the same thing, to develop a hierarchical structure, and whatever you want, it's okay with me.
Is that an output that you can get using the software you showed before, or what?
For Fabio Paterno, not. For the UTERP, the things I just showed you, yes. So this one, for instance. This is a workflow example. So this is about a teacher who needs books for the course. So he could choose a book, and this is in a new term, that would be an event. So it's now September, we start a new course, so I can choose a book. I order the book, this goes to the bookseller who processes the order, and to the finance administrator who will check whether there's enough money for that. Then the bookseller would send a bill to the financial administrator and a book to me, and then he has to receive the bill, to register, and to pay. So this is quite simple, but interesting is here. My goal, I'm the teacher, is to get a book. My goal is reached here, right? At this moment, I receive the book. The financial administrator has to maintain the budget, which is very brief. He checks whether there's enough money, he says, yes, you can order the book. And then later on, he has to pay the bill and to keep an inventory. So you can see there are several goals that have a start and a moment when the goal is reached. And interesting is this part. I'm happy, I'm a teacher, I got the book. But then there's other people who still have to pursue tasks and reach situations, right? Because I did things, so it could be very complex. So this we call kind of a workflow or a process.
Is there any connection with UML modeling? Because
you can do this in UML. Okay. Yeah, if you use UML, that's fine. But I've already started using UML. And it's completely equivalent, but it looks different, and you might have a preference for one or the other. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but UML is just the trick part, why not?
At the end would be like you need to get this kind of graphical representation of the system flow, right?
Graphical representation help. In this case it helps me to find out that I reached my goal but the process didn't stop at all. And some people still have to set goals and reach them.
Okay.
Right? And this helps in this graphical representation. Mm. There are situations that you overlook if you don't have the right representation. Okay. And by the way, Fabio only provides you with hierarchical structures, and you will never find out this,
okay.
I think. So this is why I suggest, well, try several representations.
Mm-hmm.
But there's no one that's better than the other. Any hierarchical representation makes sense, but if you would like workflow, it's a different one. And there are hundreds of different ways of producing workflow.
Mm-hmm.
As long as you have a goal, then. Because reaching the goal is important in a human task structure. People stop when they reach their goal. You might know the old ATM machines, the original ones, maybe before you were born, but there were ATM machines, you put your plastic card, you typed your PIN number, you got your money, and then you went away. And you lost your card. Because I reached my goal, getting money, and I forgot to take my card. And now they changed it, so now what you forget is take your slip, your paper. Because all the paper receipts are still there, right?
Yeah.
Because people reach their goal, they first have to take the card, then they get their money, and then the machine is still printing, and they are gone.
Yeah, probably they don't even need it.
Well, they reach their original goal. Their main goal is get cash.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe later on they said, oops, stupid, I should have taken that one. Okay, and now machines ask, do you want one, yes or no? And even then people leave them. So media registrations, you can have video, soundtrack, pictures, like a media picture of an activity, or scan of an example that's on the website of a very complex control office, and handmade mock-ups, right? But also this is relevant.